Stay tuned for an exclusive offer from our sponsor, Vikings War of Clans. Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. In a world where everyone is talking about losing weight fast, Triangle Bob came up with an interesting idea. He said that people should just get rid of those useless white sticks inside their body. Bones, Triangle Bob, they're called bones. Anyway, silly weight loss schemes aside, could you actually live without bones? I know this sounds like a crazy question. Obviously, your bones are a pretty important part of your body. But why? There are 206 of them in the average adult, and babies are actually born with even more, around 300 or so. Some bones are long and thick, with the longest being the femur or the thigh bone, while others are thin and flat, like shoulder blades. The smallest bones in your body are in your ear. Bones have two types of bone tissue, compact bone and spongy bone. No. Hey, isn't that guy copyrighted? Get him out of here. Compact bone is dense and heavy. It needs to be strong as it's the outside layer of the bone. Spongy bone is lighter and less dense. Bone marrow is also found inside of your bones, and it's a soft tissue with two types, red and yellow. Red bone marrow is where red and white blood cells are made, and yellow bone marrow is mostly made of fat. So, could you live without bones? At least the way our bodies currently function, I'd have to say no. Unless you want to be a lifeless pool of human goop on the floor, in which case, go for it, I guess? Since your muscles are attached to the bones of your skeleton, without them, you simply wouldn't be able to move. Just the spine itself, which is made up of 24 small bones called vertebrae, is necessary if you want to keep yourself upright or even stand at all. Maybe that's okay for a lazy day of watching TV, but other than that, I'd have to get Triangle Bob to carry me around on his back all the time. And I am not some Jedi Master, so it probably wouldn't work out. Beyond that, there wouldn't be anything to protect your vital organs, and your brain would especially be in danger. You'd be one heavy metal concert away from kicking the bucket. However, it is possible to live without some of your bones. For instance, some people with the condition cleidocranial dysostosis are born without their collarbones, or have them abnormally developed. There are also a bunch of animals that don't have a skeleton at all, and they get along just fine. The octopus is one of my favorites, but others include jellyfish and spiders who have a hard outer shell called an exoskeleton instead of a skeleton inside their bodies. That makes them even more creepy. So I hope you learned a thing or two about bones, and let us know in the comment section below, what should we talk about next? Thanks again to Vikings War of Clans for sponsoring this video. Vikings just went through a really massive update with new RPG elements and a new hero. If you remember TOP strategy and RPG games from the 90s and 2000s, which everyone was crazy about, you will definitely love Vikings. This game gives you an option to choose your own playstyle, build an impenetrable city, create a booming economy, use your diplomacy skills to rule the world, and build a huge army and destroy enemy castles. I especially love that I can play with my friends. No, not you, Triangle Bob, get out of here. Play it for just 5 minutes and you'll see why it has over 12 million people hooked. Support Life Noggin today and download Vikings from the first link in the description and get your initial protection shield for free and my special bonus of 200 gold for a fast and successful start. My name is Blocko, this has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.